Look at that. Green grass. Well, yeah, 800. We are at the field. Absolutely fantastic weather with a nice bright sun. So yeah, this is the newest addition to my fleet, the Protos 800X Evo. This is the big boy. See if I can get this canopy off with one hand. And there she is. Let's take a closer look. We are running the Eagle Drift 4530 HT 370 kV Scorpion Tribunus 2 14200 amp ESC. This is a 14S setup. I'll show you the batteries here in just a minute. KST X20 servos. They are the 2208s and 1035. Running Brain 2, of course. And these are the RotorTech 810 and 116s. As I said, we are running 14S LiPo, so we've got the Mania X, Mania 10, Maniacs, whatever you want to call them. 14S stick packs, 5100 milliamp hour 70C. Got two of them. Anyway, let's put that on pause for just a second and talk about the 380. I got a question from a friend on the Hangout asking me to go a little bit into detail on what exactly the difference is on the V2 frame layout on the Protos 380. So, let me take the canopy off real quick. So this is my Protos 380 XL Power version with the V2 frame upgrade. I'm sure by now you've heard of this or seen it or, you know, something, but in short, what we're doing is taking these servos from being kind of like right here and then like one on the side, and instead they're both on the side and then one up front. The biggest thing for me that I like about it is the fact that you can now easily access the servo horn screws. So if you ever need a change those horns out, it's a pretty simple and easy process. It also, size of the carbon is a little bit thicker, so the stock frames on the 380 is 1.2 millimeters, and on the V2, both the conversion and the actual V2 kits, they are 1.5 millimeters, so quite a bit stronger as well, and less likely to snap. So yeah, that's the short and sweet explanation of the V2 versus V1. You may have noticed that I don't have boom supports on here. I decided to take them off and go strutless. I was told that it handles it just fine, so we'll be doing that. And I think it looks a little better than the boom supports, so I'm gonna fly it. Also, I have installed the palm dampers in the 380 as well. So all of my helicopters now have the palm dampers installed. I've been meaning to get them for this for a while and I just haven't, so I finally picked them up and they're in there now and we're gonna see the difference. Really nothing new about the Spectre. It's just trucking along like the great little helicopter it is. So, I do have one more update. I got a new radio. So as you know, most likely, I have been flying with a Free Sky Horus X10S for the last several years. I got the X10S Express, which has the new access protocol. And I got it in the carbon fiber scheme because I think it looks sick. So this is what I'm flying now. So the reason I got the Express, nothing wrong with the X10S at all. Still a great radio, still have it. But the reason I got this is I wanted to take advantage of the access protocol and the receivers that come with it. So on the 800 and the 380, I have the Archer RS receivers. You can run one wire from your receiver to your gyro and get control and telemetry through it, rather than having to use the adapter cable. So yeah, like I was saying, the 800 and the 380 have it. I have more receivers on the way, which I will be putting on the rest of my helicopters. The Spectre still has the X8R receiver running ACCST. Eventually, I'll be flying all of them on the Access and on this radio. And lastly, one more, I know I said that last time, but one more small update. I don't have it to show here, but the OnePlus and M18 battery adapters for the Dynatron are done and up for sale now on my website, which is right here. And yeah, so you can grab those now. Like I said, I don't have one with me, obviously, because I don't have any nitros with me, but go check those out. There will be a link in the description. So I think without further ado, let's get to it. I'm going to do the 380 first and then go from there. There will be a couple more people showing up to the field, I know that. It'll be Marion and Ian Joel. So we're going to be flying together and having a fantastic day.
Absolutely more locked in. Way more like, it feels really direct. Cyclic gain just a little. And tail gain. Yeah, it definitely flies a lot better with these. Yeah. There's a bug on my ear.
So let's talk about that. Yeah, palm dampers, such a big difference, honestly. That's why I got them for all of my helicopters so far, it makes it so much more locked in. I would highly recommend picking up a set of these dampers. There'll be a link in the doobly-doo. Still waiting on my friends to show up, so I'm gonna go for another flight on the 380. I'm not gonna record this one, just gonna have some fun, and I'll be back. Yeah, I brought my generator and my charger. This thing is really nice for the money. It's less than $500 for a 1600 watt, pretty dang quiet generator. Who needs a Honda? There he is. What do we got?
You already got nothing like you.
Well, that's fine.
I got a... Got that bad boy.
Wow.
It rolls.
Where's the new quad?
I don't tell me, I done forgot.
Oh,
no.
What about it for the... What?
I forgot my, charger. Shit.
A charger?
Yeah.
I have a charger.
No, huh?
I got
no,
a charger.
I forgot my charger, but it has my damn batteries in it, man. After that.
You always forget something, don't you?
Yeah.
Forgot your radio and you had to go get it.
Yep.
But you gotta
know. Hold on, wait a second.
Is that that one?
No.
Or was it the other one?
Look at that. I can't believe that. That has a... Look at my oxy too, man. Let's see.
Oh, you got the raw canopy?
Huh? Nah, I've had this canopy for years.
They move the tables around. They used to be right next to each other.
Oh. Have you flown that?
Not yet. I was waiting for y'all.
Oh, okay. Cool. Damn, I can't believe it. It's always something, man. So that made it lighter. What else did I do? It has 3-inch props on it. I think it weighs dry. I think it's 80 grams.
Dude, it's like 90% battery.
Yeah.
blades. This looks familiar. I printed this for him.
It moves up.
The sun is behind some clouds now.
So I felt a little puny there.
This man pulled up on me while I was flying. What do we got?
Got those two.
Interesting. What was that you said?
I'm just gonna do a little butter flight with this.
Butter.
Yeah, butter. Get the shakes out.
Okay.
Then after that, you can go ahead and fly Keith's.
He don't want to crash it yet. He's going to spring plane.
Keith hasn't even flown Keith's 800.
Oh, dude. Find a nice little mound.
There you go.
All right.
Send it.
It's the game plan.
Motor idle.
It's just over there soldering. Idle up?
Uh-huh.
Okay, just making sure.
No, I'm just worried about the tail kicking out.
spinach. Timer, 1 minute.
It's really smooth. It
sounds good.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised. I thought this thing was going to be just uncontrollable.
Crank the head speed up a little bit. It might be.
Well,
that's three.
That's 2500, but it's got a little bit of a tail twitch. And
that's nothing.
At spring fling, I'm going to try to land this thing inverted.
Okay. You know that's called crashing, right?
Motor idle. Motor off.
Yay.
You done soldering yet?
Huh? For me?
Yeah.
I wonder if I got a porta potty or something.
I'm thinking it's time.
Oh yeah?
What do you think?
I don't know, it does look pretty.
Throttle hold.
Good Lord, she's out there. Yeah, the blade hurts.
Pretty big.
Time to look at everything and make sure nothing's falling out. I'll be back. Yup, I love it. Got Iaen up in the air. Just about to land. Got the battery that I just flew on the charger, giving my generator a workout. Got one more charge right now, but I'm gonna do another flight on the Protos 380 real quick. Just,
woo!
The heck was that? What'd you do? So yeah, that's what's up next.
380 time.
Thank you.
seconds.
All right, I think what I'm gonna do next is, what do you think, 800?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna crank the head speed to 1700. That's the middle speed. Go ahead and get her powered up and get her in the air.
Right there, too. 3 minutes. flight mode 2.
Hello.
That's interesting.
What's that?
The tail doing that
thing. 30 seconds. Holder idle. Holder off.
The dirty. Boing, boing.
This thing is fucking nuts. There's a couple
of... Oh!
Oh, that's cool, man. They meant to...
Gonna send the Spectre again. Let's do it.
Thank you. throttle hold. Reset.
3 minutes and 40 seconds.
Thank you. flight mode 2, flight mode 1. Throttle hold.
That was rough. Not yet. Eventually.
Bad. Not too bad at all. And we're going up again with the 800. Just trying to get used to how it flies and making sure it's all tuned in and everything.
flight mode 1. Throttle hold.
Man, the sounds this thing makes. Wonderful. See how hot that is? A little hot, but far from too hot. Let's check out my specs. 133 amps. ESC barely hit 50 degrees. Not bad. Not bad at all. The sun has kind of been off and on throughout the day, and now it's behind clouds, way behind us. So I think from now till we're done, it's gonna be cloudy and windy. It's gotten pretty windy throughout the day, evening. So, but bigger hellos don't care. So I think I've got one more battery for the 700 and one more for the 800, and perhaps one for the 380, I'm not sure. And I think that'll be it for the day. So I think next up's gonna be the 700, so let's do it.
Batteries are not having it.
Throttle hold.
Visibility is getting worse.
Huh?
visibility is getting worse. I think I'll not fly the 800 again. I mean, it's probably more visible than 700, but still.
I'll just save it for another day. So, I have decided not to fly the 800 one more time, because you know what they say, right? One more flight means crash. So, the weather's getting kind of crappy. I think it's fixing to rain soon, and it's kind of windy, and it's getting cold. So I'm gonna do a quick flight on 380 just to drain that battery, and then we're gonna head out.
Do a speed pass.
Another one.
Throttle hold.
Well, I think that's it for the day. It's really starting to cool down and visibility's not too great anymore, so
I think
we're gonna call it for the night and take everything home in one piece. And see you in the next one. If you're gonna be at the Spring Fling this year, I will see you there. Here later in the month. Otherwise, I'll see you in future videos. Bye bye. Bye bye. Say bye.
Bye bye. Peace.
All right, see you guys.